All right, WWDC just wrapped and Apple Intelligence is now a reality. I feel like this is Apple's biggest master plan yet. I'll tell you why at the end of the video, because before, we've got a lot to talk about. Let's dive in.
Okay, so if Apple made artificial intelligence, how would that look like? And that's exactly what Apple Intelligence is. They basically grabbed the entire Apple ecosystem and sprinkled AI all over it, which is exactly what makes Apple Intelligence different. That is exactly what makes Apple different. It's their ecosystem. So Apple Intelligence is compatible on the Mac, on the iPad, and on the iPhone. It is not available on the Apple Watch, which I'm kind of upset about, and I was really expecting to get tons of AI features on the watch, but I guess we're gonna have to wait for that. All right, so let's go over the major features coming to Apple Intelligence, starting off with writing tools. We've seen this before, but you can actually grab an email or a piece of text, and writing tools can make your text more friendly, more professional, or more concise. You can also make an entire summary of that text, make key points, a table, a list. You can even proofread your text so there's no mistakes. Custom AI generated emojis was a feature that we were all waiting for, and it's finally here. And that's what Genmoji is. So you can ask things like, I want a T-Rex surfing on a surfboard. Smiling face with cucumbers, it can do that. There's an app that I've talked about in the channel before called Muji, which does exactly that. So if you don't want to wait with iOS 18, you can currently do that now. You can literally make an emoji of Messi or LeBron James or Tim Cook. Now, what makes Muji truly different is that since Apple Intelligence know who's in your photo library, you can literally ask it, make an emoji of mom riding a motorcycle. Make an emoji of Joss playing basketball. You can ask it whatever you want within your photo library of your family and friends. I mean, that's pretty cool. There's also Image Playground, which is basically an image generator. You can ask it to generate an image of whatever you want using AI. And then there's different styles as well. You can choose between three styles: animation, illustration, or sketch. Now, once again, since Apple Intelligence has your photo library, it also has your contacts. So, as Apple said in the keynote, you can literally make a custom birthday image of your friend. Since it knows your contacts, it grabs that contact info, it knows that contact photo, and it will generate all of that. That's truly Apple. Once again, if Apple did AI, how would that look like? That's how I would imagine Apple doing it. It's great. Now, once again, getting in the ecosystem, Image Wand is something genius as well. If you go inside of Freeform, for example, and you're writing something and you're drawing something, let's say you sketched out a tree, you can circle or highlight that tree, and AI, Apple Intelligence, will generate an image of a tree inside of your Freeform inspiration board. Not only that, but when you circle on the image, it will also get all the information, all the text, all the handwritten text as well. It will grab all of that information to make that drawing the most accurate possible. Siri is pretty much the protagonist of Apple Intelligence of AI. First of all, it's been totally redesigned. Instead of being that circle waveform, which I've loved all my life, Siri just turned up. Be quiet. It will now kind of be a waveform all around the iPhone, which I personally think it looks great. Apple is calling this new generation of Siri natural language, which lets you basically speak to Siri more naturally, more like if you were speaking to your friend. And that's what makes all these other AIs so great. That's what makes it so great talking to ChatGPT, because you don't really feel like you're talking to a robot. You can literally just talk AI naturally and you expect it to talk back. And with Siri, that was never the case. But now with natural language, you can be like, hey, what's the weather in Cupertino? Oh no, sorry, in Barcelona. And it will know that. If you did this with Siri now, it would be like, sorry, I don't understand. And also what's so amazing with ChatGPT, for example, is that it always remembers what you're talking about, right? With Siri, if you ask it one thing and then 5 minutes later you come back to it, Siri just forgot about it, but now it knows what you were talking about, right? So if you just ask it for the weather and then ask to schedule a meeting from that location, it will understand, it will remember all of that for you. And that's what makes AI so great. And now that coming to Apple Intelligence, to the iPhone, to the iPad, and to the Mac is just so incredible. Personal context is another super powerful feature, which I personally think I'm gonna use so much. So it basically grabs information from all the services, from email to calendar to photos, and it will basically be able to read all of that. So you can ask Siri, when is my mom landing on her flight? And it will search via a text message, a text that your mom sent you, that your mom is arriving tomorrow. And it will do all of that automatically. Or if you can't find that concert ticket that is under your email, it will find that. If you're looking for your ID, you ask Siri, hey, what's my ID number? It will go inside of your Photos app and just search like crazy. In just a second, you'll have a photo of your ID. Now, one of the things that I love about ChatGPT and other AI software is that you can literally type in to AI. And now with Siri, now with Apple Intelligence, you can now type in to Siri with simply a double tap in the bottom of your iPhone. It will open a text form that you can ask it whatever you want. Now, what surprised us the most at the event was the actual integration with other AI platforms such as ChatGPT. We thought Apple Intelligence was technically going to compete with ChatGPT, but the coolest thing is that ChatGPT will actually integrate directly to Apple Intelligence in iOS 18. So you'll be able to use Apple Intelligence for certain things that maybe they do better than ChatGPT, but Apple's like, hey, maybe you like ChatGPT better for certain things, so you can do that as well. And that's something that is kind of the new Apple, right? Letting other platforms being on board. I mean, Apple is smart here, right? ChatGPT is so amazing. And OpenAI has changed AI forever, right? So them being on board. And Craig even told us at an event that we went to that the plans are to be open about this, right? Gemini being on board. I mean, the plans for Apple Intelligence isn't just about Apple. And I think Apple having such an open mind about this is truly what makes Apple Intelligence different, unique. The Apple ecosystem support, which we've all been asking for, and the integrations with other AIs is going to change everything. Let me know in the comments down below what you think of Apple Intelligence. Subscribe if you're new, and yeah, tons more WWDC 24 coverage coming soon on the channel. So if you're new, I definitely subscribe. Bye-bye.